Sea snakes, or Hydrophinae, belongs to the Elapidae family, known for being extremely venomous. They are aquatic reptiles which make up 85% of the known saltwater reptile species. Most sea snakes are extremely well adapted to live entirely in water environments. These are called true sea snakes because they will live in the water their entire lives. But some rascals like the sea crate are amphibious and come on land to rest and lay eggs. We will only be focusing on sea snakes today. Sorry, sea crate, you should have stayed in the water. They are most commonly found in coral reefs and river mouths of tropical coastal areas. Sea snakes only live in the Indian and Western Pacific Ocean region. Now, sea snakes are benthic foragers, meaning that they eat crabs, fish, and octopus. Now, some other species can use their venom to stun larger prey and swallow it whole. Look at this eel. It looks like it's having a rather stunning evening. Oh, moving on. They are suited with a vertically flattened tail to propel themselves in the water. Like most snakes, they have a forked tongue, but their nostrils have flaps to make breathing easier for them. Snakes come to the surface to breathe air and store it in their large lungs. They can also release the excess carbon dioxide through their skin with specialized blood-filled scales. Sea snakes are dioecious, meaning that they mate using male and female parts. They only mate annually during the September and October months. Interestingly, these are the only reptiles to give birth live in the water. Mating males will perform a mating dance to attract a potential mate. It will look kind of like it's swimming around normally, but apparently that gets the lady snakes going. Now, the male has a total of 2 inverted penises stored in the tail, yet only one of them is used for mating. Impressive. Once the 2 partners meet up, they reenact keeping wired headphones in your pocket for too long, then the deed is done. Female snakes give birth to a live litter of up to 30 little baby snakes. They are born relatively large. To demonstrate what a live birth looks like, here is my friend Andy to show you.
Have a look at this. We're live on the Little Walnut Creek. Have a look at this snake. This could be the northern water snake. And isn't she gorgeous? Check this out. She's a real whopper. Oh, what a beauty. Check this out. If I go in, she could give me a nasty bite. The northern water snake, there goes a baby. Check this out. There's a little baby. Is she giving birth right now? Have a look at this.
Thanks, Andy. Isn't nature beautiful? Most sea snakes are lucky enough not to be on the CITES, or Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species. That does not include the endangered Crocker's sea snake and several species of the Apisaurus, however. Unfortunately, 2 leaf-scaled species are listed as critically endangered, previously thought to be extinct. Finding the exact number of sea snakes is difficult, but there are a total of 52 species found throughout the Indian and Pacific coastal regions. Due to the rising number of eco-terrorists in the world, the ocean temperatures are slowly rising, as you know. Because sea snakes often live in coral reefs, they rely on its health to survive. Coral reef bleaching poses the biggest threat to the snake's habitat and their health. They are also hunted for their meat and leather, so think again before buying leather products. The previously thought extinct dusky sea snake is the most critically endangered. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration has listed specific sea snakes as endangered using the Endangered Species Act. Amen! This protects the species as a whole and its coral reef habitat. Now, not much is known about sea snakes, so it's hard to protect them efficiently. One of the easiest things to do is to avoid purchasing sea snake leather products. Just remember, protect those sneesakes